This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on Sorscha, our awesome warcaster for the Kador line from Privateer Press's War Machine game. Gonna do a couple of things here today. We're gonna try and finish the base up. But before we do that, I want to go ahead and lay down a base coat for the eyes, because as that base coat is drying, then we can come in and work on the base. By the time the base gets done, at least as far as we get done putting on the second base coat for the base, the eyes should be dry, and go ahead and finish those up. That way we don't waste too much time, at least. Get a little air bubble in my brush there. Happens from time to time. Just knock it off with my paper towel. Alright. She has sufficiently raccoon-y eyes now, so let's mix up. If I would not drop my brush, that would be ideal. And where is the little protector? Always save these things, by the way, these little brush protector things. They come in very, very handy. Alright. So we're going to take these two colors, and you will forgive me, I hope, for taking a moment to mix some colors on the palette. Alright. There's one half of our mixture, and here is the other half. Just like that. Now, let's mix those two together. There we go. By the way, if you're just joining us, I know we're kind of early into the Sorscha Watch Me Work, so we might have picked up a few new viewers. If you've never seen any of our Watch Me Works before, basically what these are is just a way to watch a piece of art get created. There's very little, if any, like instruction given. It's not meant to be a tutorial, although there are occasions where I will kind of diverge and go into tutorial mode, giving various tips and tricks along the way, but for the most part, these videos are really meant just to be a just a nice, relaxing video where you can sit back, maybe do some painting of your own and have this running in the background, or whatever the case may be, but essentially this is basically just an opportunity for you guys to watch how I create a miniature, or how I paint a miniature. So there you go. That's basically the gist of it. I'm not a quick painter, for those of you that are just joining us. I am very methodical, very precise about my painting most of the time, and so it tends to take me a little bit longer. But I've got a little bit different style than most people, and so I think when you see the outcome of these models, you'll be, hopefully you'll be impressed. Or, well, maybe not impressed is not a good word, because it really doesn't matter if you're impressed or not, but hopefully you will enjoy what you see, let's put it that way. I'm not really doing this to impress anybody, just kind of doing it for fun, to be honest with you. I mean, I'm painting anyway, so I may as well cut the camera on, right? And let you guys in on the process. So, you know, for years people asked me to do more painting videos, And I thought to myself, you know, how can I do that? And it finally dawned on me one day while I was painting, why not just cut the camera on and just go to town, you know? I mean, it's not everybody's cup of tea, of course. You know, you got so many people out there that are great painters, but, you know, their videos maybe 15, 20 minutes long, and, you know, they're using an airbrush, or they're doing kind of what I'm doing, but they've got the video sped up, 8 to 16 times normal speed, and they're doing a little voiceover on it or something like that. But I like just doing it in real time. To me, it's fun that way, and we get to be different, and different's good, most of the time anyway. So hopefully you enjoy these videos, and hopefully they'll bring some delight to your day whenever you see one show up in your inbox. Alright, so that's base coated out. Now let's move back to the eyes, because I'll bet our brown is dry. And let's see if we can create some eyes for this miniature. I need... where is the color that I need? Oh, it's right in front of my face. Quite literally. Alright, so let's shake this up.
Shake it up.
Little dab on the plate there. And put that back in its spot. Now, we need a small, tiny, tiny brush for this. And let's see what we can do here. Just want to get a little water in this so it flows. And we'll see what kind of creation we can come up with. I also want to make sure that I am in the frame. I have a tendency to not be in the frame many, many times. And that's okay, because we can fix it. But it would be nice if you guys could see what I was doing. Probably. I mean, I don't know. You might not care one way or the other. You might just be listening to me. In which case, that's fine too. I'm just glad you're here, you know? Glad that you found me important enough to click on. Or at least entertaining enough to click on. Alright. So there's probably one eye. We'll see how it kind of looks once I flesh it out a little bit more. And here's probably another eye. Don't you just love that commitment? It might be an eye, it might not be, I don't know, whatever. Dab there, and that actually looks a lot better than the other one. I think it's just because of the position in the head there, but it's all right. We will knock our miniature over. That's exactly what we'll do. I was gonna say we will prevail, but you know what? Knocking the miniature over is more fun. Because then we get to prevail twice. The first time we did it, and then when we go back and fix our screw-up that we chipped the paint off of. So, let's see here. Now we're going to come in with a pupil, or attempt to at least. And see how this looks. Alright. Let's see what we can do. Real thin set of... roll up on the brush, a little roll up of the bristles. That was really sad. So we're going to do that again. Go back to the cream color. And touch the eyeball again. Blob. That's not how you paint an eye, Christopher. That's how we do it here. We blob. Alright. We might not even make it to the base at this point. Jeez. Alright, let's see here. Okay. Alright, thin paint. It's nice and watery, so it's going to flow. We'll start with the left eye this time. Ooh, we got an eye. That's an eye right there, baby. I will take that one. Alright. So we got one. Let me zoom in so you can see it. Ta-da! Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta! Alright, so there's one eyeball. Now we gotta do the other one. Or I gotta get some green stuff and make an eye patch. One or the other. I'd prefer to do the eye. But that's just me. So, let's see if we can do it. Let me rephrase, because I know I can do it. It's just a matter of, let's see how many times it takes before I get it right. Why? Because everybody sucks at painting eyes, that's why. Alright, so that eyeball is kind of looking pretty much straight, which is good, because that's kind of the way I want it to go. That's not really straight. So, for the third time, let's repaint the eyeball. Well, I guess technically it's the second time we're repainting. Third time we're painting.
Shut up.
Alright. Glob the paint into place. Alright. Ooh, wow, look at that. How exciting. My fingers are rubbing paint off the back of the base. So, while we're waiting for the cream color to dry, let's come back and touch the back of the base with some base color. Ooh, yay, look at that. See those white flakes coming off right there on the edges? There we go. That indicates to me that as soon as we finish the base, we need to spray the entire miniature with Tester's Dull Coat. Because I guarantee you, these little pokey parts are probably going to get touched a lot during the painting process. And that may be an indication to me that I need to hold off on dry brushing the base until we make it further through the miniature. In fact, that's probably a good idea, to be honest with you. Just lay down that base color to start with. And, I mean, truthfully, really the only area that we're going to have to avoid when we do the dry brush are the boots. So we could paint everything on the model except the boots and then go paint the base, and we'd be okay. We wouldn't have to worry about hitting the rest of the miniature with the color. So I think we'll do that, actually. So we will dedicate this video to simply painting the eyeball of the miniature, or the eyeballs, or eyeball, depending on how many we get done. If this takes 40 minutes, I guarantee you it's going to be two videos. So we'll see what happens, but I'm going to attempt to do this one more time. Nice, I got it correct this time. Son of a monkey. Man, I'm telling you. She's got like this lazy eye going on. Like one eye's looking mostly straight, and the other one's kind of looking at the Coke machine over to the right side. That's a Family Guy reference for those of you that didn't get that one. I haven't seen that show in years. I used to watch it all the time. I have not seen it in quite some time. Alright. Yet again, rinsing the brush off. What's this, try number four, I think? I don't know. Place your bets in the comment section. How many times is it going to work? Or how many times is it going to take for me to get this correct? I'm hoping four. But we'll see. Alright, so... you know what? Can I do this upside down? Will that be easier? Not really. I can't tell where I'm poking if I do it upside down. That's alright. We'll do it this way and just hope we get it right. Come on. Alright, we got the pupil relatively in the correct spot, it's just not big enough. There we go, that'll work. Ha ha, four it is. If you guess four, you get a gold star. Alright, where's my brown? I put the brown away. Here's the brown. Here's the pile that I... oh, good lord, that was a lot of brown. Wow, that came out much more rapidly than I had anticipated. But that's okay. Alright, so... now, we just make the fixes. Holy cow, that's awful looking. Alright, get rid of some of that paint. There we go. Okay, good. Am I still in frame? I am in frame. Okay, that's a good starting spot. Alright, let's do the underside now. Okay. Outstanding. Fan-flippin-tastic. Now, let's not screw this eye up, and we'll be in great shape. Alright. I apologize if you can't see what I'm doing. I'm having to hold the miniature, like, completely upside down in order to see the underside of the eyelid. So, forgive me, please. Ooh, that was so close, but perfect. Just like I knew it would be. Exactly. All right. Wonderful. Okay, so our miniature now has two pretty decent looking eyes. Let me zoom in so you can see them. Ta-da! Both of them looking pretty much relatively in the same direction. Let's see, which one looks like on the camera? Let's see, that would be the one furthest, so it would be the one on this side. Okay, now you can see it. I couldn't see the white around the eye on that side, on closest to the nose there for a moment, but I guess it was just the way I was holding the miniature. I think I had it like that when I needed to rotate it slightly. Like that. So we have two good eyes now on our miniature, and we have a base that's been base coated, but despite my desire, actually doesn't need to be dry brushed yet. So we're just going to leave that like it is, because I foresee lots of white spots appearing on the back, and probably once I'm painting the back, probably the front of this miniature too, because I guarantee you I'm going to be putting my fat finger right here the whole time I'm painting. So there's no real reason to dry brush this right now. But at least we get an idea of how it's going to look in the end, or at least a starting place of how it's going to look. So anyway, I think that's going to do it for this video. There's not a whole lot much more I can do. I could base coat the hair, but I don't want to. I got to figure out which color I'm going to use. I know the hair is going to be brown. I just don't know which brown it's going to be yet. But we'll cross that bridge in the next video, I suppose. I think next time we'll attempt to tackle both the hair and maybe this fuzzy hat that she's wearing, and perhaps something else. I don't know. We'll see. But for right now, we'll call that a pretty decent start to a miniature, and we'll leave it there. So if you happen to have any comments or questions, drop those down in that comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Again, I want to thank you all for watching. It means a whole lot to us. And that's it for today, guys. So God bless you all. Have a phenomenal day, and I will see you all in the next video.